Been the tale of two cities, Minneapolis and or versus St. Paul, depending on how you want to look at it. But now those who love the capital city for what it is have birthed the slogan, a movement, keep St. Paul boring.
That actually started as an inside joke, but it's now turned into a debate over the smaller twins' true identity. Chris Rapsky is getting to the bottom of it.
Is St. Paul boring?
The quiet twin is sometimes the way to go.
That's the debate swirling around a t-shirt and bumper sticker campaign based on the slogan, Keep St. Paul Boring.
The shirt sold well in Minneapolis, in our Minneapolis store, but once we opened the St. Paul store, it's really taken off.
So wait a minute, is the shirt supposed to be flattering or insulting? Is St. Paul actually boring? And if so, should you keep it that way? What does that even mean? So many questions.
Keep St. Paul boring kind of has a couple layers to its meaning.
We met up with Nick Hanula, the man who coined the phrase roughly 18 months ago and decided to put it on some shirts.
It's an ironic look at how people view St. Paul.
So you don't believe St. Paul's boring?
St. Paul is not boring. I love St. Paul.
But you think that people think St. Paul's boring?
Exactly.
The idea was more of a piggyback from a similar concept in North Carolina that used the slogan, Keep Raleigh Boring.
I thought, you know, that kind of really works well here. There is a certain set of St. Paulites who tend to oppose the sort of change, and it's also a little bit of a poke at them saying, you know, you're trying to keep St. Paul boring and we're not.
Do you think the mayor hates you?
Well, no, probably not. Hope not.
Is St. Paul boring?
Well, you know, it's got a reputation to uphold.
St. Paul Mayor Chris Coleman gets the shirt. It's funny. It's a play on what St. Paul used to be and what it has become. As he says, the slogan is born out of love for St. Paul.
I remember seeing a sign in New York. A homeless person was sitting on the corner and they had a sign that said, if you want to give me money, fine, but I'm not going to beg for it. So it's kind of, it's a little bit of a version of that, which is like, if you want to come out and hang out in St. Paul and go to all the great things that we have going on, fine, but we're not going to beg you to come.
Interesting analogy. So if the phrase isn't true, what makes St. Paul not boring?
The Nook.
One of the most beautiful riverfronts in the country.
CHS Field in Lower Town.
We got a peg that brings up balls. I mean, how much more exciting can you get than that?
Grand Old Days, I live on Grand, so I get to experience that every year.
Double bonus.
You've got Crashed Ice.
Crashed Ice.
You got to finish.
NPR?
Current. You got the current.
And if you're not down with any of that, you could just go across the river.
I heard there's a city across the river that they can go to.
Which one is that? Hudson?
South St. Paul.
So, that's a little something else here. Nick wants to go beyond just doing shirts and bumper stickers, and he wants to find a building wall to paint a mural that says Keep St. Paul Boring on it this summer.
You should ask the mayor for him.
He'll do it. I mean, own it, right? You just got to own it and you flip it around. By the way, his shirts are available on Etsy. You just got to search for Keep St. Paul Boring. And then the I Like You Too store in St. Paul has them as well.
Would you like to apologize to poor NPR?
It was a joke. You got to own it.
Funny? I love NPR. They're not boring.
So do I.
They're awesome.
So do I. It was a, you guys.
It's fine. We like St. Paul.
Here comes the next t-shirt. Keep NPR boring.
All right. I didn't say that.
All right.
Keep
thanks,
ETM
Chris.
Boring. Yep.
All right. Well, do you have a food that makes you happy? One that maybe.